Heat does not discriminate. It can be dangerous, even if you've lived here your whole life.
For every person who loves a good 100-plus day, there's another, of course, who wishes it wasn't quite so hot. It takes a lot to churn out a 118-degree day.
It is one of Mother Nature's most massive shows, and new for you at 6, a unique way to illustrate how the science of summer really works.
You'll only get to see this on ABC 15 Arizona. Here's Megan Thompson.
The sun can be described as a great big ball of fire. And with our temperatures, you're probably feeling like you're right up next to those flames. So we're going back to basics tonight with the kids to figure out why is our state so hot.
Here we are in our low energy state.
Many of these families came here to escape the outdoors.
This is sometimes how heat gets transferred, is stuff bumping into each other.
But Matt Huntley allowing these kids to be a part of the heat with this demonstration.
And then a ton of heat energy from lights start running around. Go, 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 go.
This a way to show us what heat actually is.
Heat is a measure of motion. That's the point. When we measure heat and we measure temperature, we're measuring how much molecules are moving around.
And as for why Arizona gets the brunt of it, Huntley says we can blame that on where we sit along the equator, as that spot gets the most heat and heat rises.
And that hot air falling down also creates a high pressure system, which is pretty much here in Arizona all the time, which keeps out moisture, keeps it very, very clear, and that just makes it even hotter.
That's going up.
And the concrete jungle of Phoenix not helping.
All those materials have really high heat capacity. That means they hold a lot of heat.
So from where we're located on the globe to what we've built around us, the roughly 120 degrees.
Don't try us at home.
Is just part of the deal of living in the desert.
One.
Reporting in Phoenix, Megan Thompson, ABC 15, Arizona. Yeah, pretty.